The first one is organizational information requirements. Every company is different, and organizational requirements are the owner or the appointing party's requirements when it comes to their strategy and really why they get out of bed in the morning. Those requirements are going to be different between a technology company and a casino operator. A technology company might be very interested in portraying a very green and forward-looking and leading approach, whereas a casino operator is going to be focused on opening the building, maybe the client experience and path through a building, understanding that in a lot more detail. So we have some templates to help teams to unpack what their organizational requirements are to get started.
When it comes to the project information, then we might have to approach different projects and realization of different assets and facilities, then we have different circumstances. So in an example, a renovation and a new build might have to be approached differently. So that's something that recorded a project information requirement.
Yep. And do we have a template for that?
Oh yeah, we happen to have a template for that.
And then the asset information requirements, again, depend on the type of asset or type of building. The asset could be anything. It could be a specific object or an element inside, maybe a pump, or it could be the asset at large for the whole building. And when it comes to a medical office building versus a hospital, you're going to have many different assets. And being able to coordinate those information requirements and understand what those are for maintenance and for ongoing life cycle costing, for example, for that project, they're going to be very, very different. And do we have templates for that? Yes, we do. We have a list of potential assets and a never-ending list of all of the elements that we might have inside of a building.
So when it comes to exchange information requirements, so that's the combination of the previously mentioned organizational asset and project information requirements. And this is really a contractual document when the owner, client, or using the right terms, the appointing party would be sending out to potential project participants to tender on that document and return their way of approaching the project and executing the project and realizing the project. We do have a template for that, of course, but in a perfect world, you might want to use your existing documents or use the OIR, AIR, and PIR documents that we are providing to you and assemble your project-specific EIR in the application.
Absolutely. And then when we start a project, there's a concept of testing and being able to make sure that the project is essentially ready for the project team. So we've got checklists and ability there inside of Planoly to have those requirements checked for whether the CDE is up and running and whether the workflows are good.
If something can go wrong, it will. In the risk register, of course, we can be somehow prepared and just think through and document some of the risks that we might have to encounter and of course, set some mitigation measures. So we are actually planning early, right? And we do have a template for that as well.
We do have a template for that. And it helps teams to understand which are the important risks and how to mitigate them and assign them to an owner, making sure that it's a complete loop, not just a checklist where somebody says, yes, we've got one. It actually has a workflow in there as well. And then when we talk about BIM execution plans, this is one of the most talked about documents. We do have a template for that. But the principle is that this is broken into two parts. One as an answer to the employer, to the owner, to the appointing party's requirements. And then as you start to work on the project, you will build and continually improve one. And this is really how the project team will be delivering. What are the processes? What are the steps that teams are going to go through? This is the rubber meets the road.
TIDP, MIDP, the task and master information delivery plan. So to put it in very wrong and very simple, this is a task list. So each and every task team that are assigned a certain activity or a certain task to be carried out, they would put together their to-do list and they would put together how they are going to execute and carry out those tasks. And that would be the task information delivery plan. But of course, the lead appointed parties, the ones who are in charge of bringing things together, they can assemble what is called a master information delivery plan. So that's a set of task information delivery plans combined. And that's going to be the way of carrying out the project in the end. And oh yeah, we happen to have a template for that.
We have a template for that. Great. And then RACI charts, lots of people pronounce these differently. But how do you assign accountability to a team, responsibility to a team member, and then have consulted people at the right times and people that are informed about the ongoing and maybe the results of something? So it really is responsible, accountable, consulted, informed, but we really understand it much more as the team is accountable and being able to assign somebody specifically as a responsible person. That's really, really, really powerful to not just have a list of tasks, but make sure that they are assigned to the right teams. So inside of the RACI charts, you see all of those ISO 19650 clauses and then a grid to be able to assign who is responsible, who is accountable, who needs to be consulted, and who needs to be informed.
And then the responsibility matrix. So that's actually pretty much happened to be the essence of Planoly, the right beam at the right time by the right people for the right reasons. So really, who is doing what for what purpose in what point in time, that's what we can document in Planoly. And that's what we are going to visually communicate to other project participants.
The last one is the lessons learned. So yeah, our industry has this Achilles heel, this problem of, unfortunately, every project team is created and does great things on a project, learns a lot, but then is disbanded at the end of the project. So we have lessons learned templates and workflows to capture all the way through the entire project and have it accompanying the project so that then teams can go back to similar projects before they start a next project and understand what they can maybe avoid by using those lessons learned. And it really is a very difficult thing for our industry because we build teams for every single project. Okay, so there's lots of templates. Now what?